Stop saying yes to everything. Let's improve your English vocabulary by learning different English words, phrases, and expressions you can use instead of always saying yes in English. Guys, in this video lesson, we'll be going through six different situations you may find yourself in conversational settings. We'll go through different phrases you can use to say yes, to agree, to different opinions, to requests in English. At the end of this lesson, we'll also be going through different body language and sarcasm many English speakers use, even me myself, I use, to be sarcastic at times, to say yes in conversational settings. Now guys, before we begin, if this is the first time that you're here on my YouTube channel, welcome. My name's Adriana from EnglishTeacherAdriana.com, and I help English learners improve their English, boost their confidence to finally speak English confidently. If you'd like to drastically improve your confidence speaking in English, make sure to follow the next two steps. To begin with, subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on notifications so that you get notified. You know when I post my next video lesson to help you drastically improve your confidence speaking in English. Step two, download my free audio guide. In my free audio guide, I show you exactly what you need to be doing every single day to drastically improve confidence speaking in English. Now guys, these tips that I share in my audio guide, you can be anywhere in the world. As long as you have a stable internet connection and you have motivation, the desire to do something every single day to improve your English, download my free audio guide to start learning, to start understanding what you need to be doing every single day to drastically improve your confidence speaking in English. You'll find the link to download my free audio guide in the description below this video. Click that link, enter your name, your email address, and I will send you your free audio guide. Fantastic, you've done that. Let's improve your vocabulary so that you can stop saying yes. Guys, there are many phrases and expressions we're going through in this video lesson. Let's begin with the first situation, that being saying yes to a request. Guys, this is probably one of the most common situations you'll find yourself in when somebody asks you for a favor, for a request. For example, if somebody asks you, could you please make me a cup of coffee? Now, instead of just simply answering yes, you could use these expressions. No problem, no problem, no problem, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Or sure, 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 I'll make you a cup of coffee. You could also say sure thing, I'll make you a cup of coffee. No worries, no worries, no worries, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Guys, no worries is a phrase I use quite often in conversational settings. I love it, I'm a big fan of it. It's a great way to say yes in a conversational setting. Or consider it done. Consider it done, I'll make you a cup of coffee. This is a great polite and formal expression to be using in a work setting to agree and accept a request that someone's asking you. Consider it done. Consider it done. Now the phrase, I'm on it, I'm on it. Also another way to say yes, to say that yes, you're going to do it right away. For example, I'm on it, I'm going to make your cup of coffee right now. Great phrase to be using in a conversational setting with somebody that you feel comfortable with. Not so great in a really formal situation, conversational settings with work colleagues, with friends. I'm on it, great phrase to be using. Now the phrase, I'd be delighted to, is a really nice formal, polite expression to say yes, but also to express that you really want to do this. It's a delight, it brings you happiness. You're more than happy to do something. Again, the phrase is, I'd be delighted to. I'd be delighted to make you a cup of coffee. I'd be delighted to. Now the phrase I'd love to is very similar to the phrase I'd be delighted to. Also a great phrase to be using in a professional setting to show and to express that you'd really love to do something for somebody. For example, I'd love to make you a cup of coffee. Now guys, the next three phrases, those being fine, all right, and okay, they are ways for you to say yes to a request. But if I asked you, could you make me a cup of coffee? And you answered, all right, fine, and okay, but with a negative tone. So you don't sound so happy. Your intonation isn't high. Here, this can have a negative connotation in English. For example, if you asked me, Adriana, could you make me a cup of coffee? And I answered, fine, all right, okay, I might be under the impression that you really don't want to make me a cup of coffee, but you've simply agreed just out of some sort of courtesy. Again, it doesn't necessarily mean that you don't want to, but depending on the intonation, your tone of voice that you're using, answering this question, it can have a negative connotation. But if I answered your question like this, saying fine, great, okay, it will bring about a positive connotation. But if your voice is low and you say fine, great, okay, it does have a negative connotation, and the person that you're speaking to may think that you will do this, but you're not really that happy to do that request for them. Now, another formal way of saying yes could be using the phrase gladly. Gladly, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Or absolutely, 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 I'll make you a cup of coffee. Of course, of course, of course, I'll make you a cup of coffee. You could also use certainly or definitely. For example, certainly, I'll make you a cup of coffee, or definitely, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Now, two more informal phrases I use quite often in conversational settings, those being yep and yeah. Great phrases to be using with friends, in everyday communication with family, with people that you speak with on a daily basis. Yep and yeah, great ways to say yes in English. Guys, if you're loving this lesson and you would like more lessons like this here on my channel, please let me know by smashing that like button. Hit that like button and also make sure to join the discussion in the comments below this video. And tell me something new that you've learned in this video lesson. Fantastic. So we've gone through ways to say yes to a request, but what about those situations when you want to say yes to express or to agree with an opinion? Sometimes in English, we don't simply just say yes to give more information about our thoughts, our opinion on a topic. For example, if somebody asks you their opinion on maybe somebody's hair. For example, Adriana's hair is looking pretty ugly today. If you just answered yes here, this could be a little bit blunt. Or for example, about world politics. For example, Donald Trump is a great politician. So here, instead of saying yes, we could use these other phrases. Phrase one, so true. So true, Donald Trump is a great politician. So true, Donald Trump is a great politician. Now please note that the phrase so true is informal, great to be using with friends, family, people that you know very well, not the best to be using in professional settings, but the next phrase, indeed. Indeed is a great phrase to be using in a professional setting. For example, indeed, Donald Trump is a great politician. Indeed, Donald Trump is a great politician. Another great phrase is this phrase here, my thoughts exactly. My thoughts exactly, Donald Trump is an amazing politician. My thoughts exactly, Donald Trump is an amazing politician. Also the phrase, he really is. He really is a great politician. He really is a great politician. Here you could also say it, she, depending on the subject that you're agreeing or talking about. Now, some more informal phrases you may come across in TV shows and you could use in conversational settings could be totally, totally, Donald Trump is an amazing politician. Totally, or absolutely, 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 Donald Trump is an amazing politician. Now, yep and yeah, I'm sure you already know these. Of course you can use them. Yep, Donald Trump is amazing. Or yeah, Donald Trump is amazing. You could also express this with Donald Trump is an amazing politician. This is only used in conversational settings. Guys, don't be using this in written form. Conversational settings, it's okay to use the phrase, Now moving on to the third situation, and that is accepting an offer. So you may want to accept an offer instead of simply saying yes, for example, in the situation, would you like to go to the movies with me? Or would you like to go and grab a cup of coffee with me? You could use these phrases instead. For sure. For sure, I'd love to go to the movies with you. For sure, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Or absolutely. Absolutely, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Absolutely, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Yep, yeah, or okay. Again, common phrases I'm sure you've heard a lot of in conversational settings. For example, yep, I'll go to the movies with you. Or yeah, yeah, I'll go to the movies with you. Or okay. Okay, I'll go to the movies with you. Please note, guys, with these three phrases, again, intonation is important. If you do want the other person that you're speaking with to understand that you are happy and you're not doing this because you don't want to go, intonation is important. Again, yep, yep, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Yeah, yeah, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Or, okay, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Now, a really polite and a nice way to say yes could be using the phrase, I'd love to. I'd love, for example, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Or if somebody's offering you a cup of coffee or a piece of cake, I'd love some cake, or I'd love a cup of coffee. Now, also the phrase, why not, is a nice polite phrase you could also use. For example, why not, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Why not, I'd love to go to the movies with you. Great polite phrase. Use it in conversational settings. Now, the fourth situation you may find yourself in conversational settings is when you want to say yes to confirm a fact. For example, if somebody asked me, were you born in Australia? Could say yes, but I could use some of these phrases. Phrase one, that's right. That's right, I was born in Australia. That's right, I was born in Australia. Correct? Correct, I was born in Australia. Correct, I was born in Australia. Guys, that's right and correct, a little bit more formal in comparison to the next two phrases. Next two phrases, we've gone through these a few times. Yep, yep, I was born in Australia. Or yeah, yeah, I was born in Australia. Now, the fifth situation you may find yourself in conversational settings to say yes could be to give permission to somebody to do something. For example, if I asked you, could I borrow your pen? Instead of just saying yes in this situation, you could use these phrases instead. By all means, you can borrow my pen. By all means, you can borrow my pen. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead and borrow my pen. Go ahead and borrow my pen. Be my guest, be my guest, be my guest, borrow my pen. These three phrases are great, polite phrases to give permission instead of always saying yes in conversational setting. Again, you could use the phrases yeah or yep or okay and fine to say yes. For example, yep, you can use my pen, or yeah, you can use my pen, okay, you can use my pen, and fine, you can use my pen. Great phrases to be using in conversational settings. Again, careful with the intonation when saying these in conversations. Now, the sixth situation you may find yourself in is to say yes to a suggestion. For example, maybe you're at a restaurant with friends and they say, would you like to order the fish platter? Or do you think we should order a bottle of water? Instead of just saying yes, you could use some of these phrases. Definitely, definitely, let's order the fish platter. Or absolutely, 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 let's order the fish platter. I'd love to, I'd love to, I'd love to order the fish platter. Or why not, why not, why not, let's order the fish platter. Guys, please note these three phrases are more formal, very polite phrases, but also do note that they are quite often used in informal settings as well with friends and family. Now, some informal phrases you could use could be totally, totally, let's order the fish platter. Totally, let's order the fish platter. For sure, let's order the fish platter. For sure, let's order the fish platter. All right, let's order the fish platter. All right, let's order the fish platter. Now, we've gone through six situations where you can use different phrases and expressions to say yes in English. But us English speakers in conversations, we sometimes use sounds and body language to say yes. Maybe we're busy, we've got a mouthful, or we just simply can't be bothered saying all those nice phrases and expressions. Let's go through some of them now. The first one, mm-hmm. This is a sound you may hear English speakers making if they've got their mouth full, if they can't be bothered. Mm-hmm. It means yes. Also the sound, uh-huh, uh-huh. It's a sound that I quite often make in conversational settings, in informal situations. You may have heard this in TV shows and movies. Again, uh-huh. But maybe the person that you're speaking with, they don't even make any sounds. They just make some funky body movements. One of those funky body movements could be this, just nodding their head. This in English means yes. I'm sure it also means yes in your languages. But also they could give you the thumbs up sign. So like, yeah, just this. I do this quite often, especially if I'm in some sort of conversations, really informal settings, just sounds good. Also another sign I use sometimes really informally is okay, like this. This means okay, this means yes. And yeah, I use this quite often in informal settings. If you feel comfortable to use these body languages and signs, feel free to go ahead and use them. But it is good to be able to understand these gestures and these movements so that when you are speaking with English speakers, if they do these funky movements, you know what it means. Now guys, throughout this lesson, I have mentioned a lot about the importance of using the correct tone, intonation, when saying these phrases out loud to accept and say yes in English. Now I want to talk to you a little bit about sarcasm, because if you're using the wrong tone When saying these phrases, you can appear to be a little bit sarcastic. Look, in some situations, I'm sure you don't want to be sarcastic, but in some situations, you may want to be sarcastic. I use these phrases we're going to go through with this tone when I want to be sarcastic and agree to something in English, and you can do the same when speaking in English. Now, the first phrase is, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, notice how I said that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. For example, if you ask me, Adriana, could you please make me a cup of coffee? And I said, yeah, 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 sure, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Here, this is being really, really sarcastic. Maybe I don't really want to make that cup of coffee. Maybe I'm not going to make this cup of coffee. So I use the phrase, yeah, yeah, yeah. This is really sarcastic in English. Two is the word fine, but we really exaggerate it here. For example, fine, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Again, fine, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Guys, I'm not exaggerating it here. When I do use this in conversational settings, I do say it like this, fine, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Now, if I really want to be sarcastic, I could use the word affirmative. Affirmative. This is really formal. It's not something you use every single day. And that's why it's really sarcastic. So if you ask me, Adriana, could you make me a cup of coffee? I say, affirmative. I'll make you a cup of coffee. It's just like, what is she on? Really? It's really sarcastic, guys. Affirmative. I'll make you a cup of coffee. Now the phrase very well. Very well can be a really polite way to accept a request in English, but it can also be sarcastic. For example, if you ask me, Adriana, could you make me a cup of coffee? And I say, very well, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Here, notice my intonation. Very well, I'll make you a cup of coffee. I'm taking a piss out of this phrase, this polite phrase, putting it in a situation, especially with my tone. Notice the tone. Very well, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Really don't want to do it. Maybe I won't even do it. It is extremely sarcastic, but using that tone. This is a great phrase to be using in polite situations, but if it is used in a sarcastic manner and usually with some sort of head and tone gestures, it is really, really sarcastic, guys. Also the word obviously. So if something's really clear, for example, maybe you've asked me, Adriana, could you make me a cup of coffee? And you see that I've already gone to start making you a cup of coffee. And then you've asked me, you've seen that I'm doing this, and say, obviously I'll make you a cup of coffee. Notice intonation. Obviously, I'll make you a cup of coffee. Here, I'm being really sarcastic. I am saying yes here in this situation, but I'm being very sarcastic. Guys, I hope this video lesson has helped you to better understand that you don't need to say yes to everything in English. There are different phrases and expressions you can use to better express yourself when speaking in English. Remember, it's really important to practice. I suggest that you practice today by watching this video lesson a few times and then join us in the comments below this video and answer this question. When was the last time you had to say yes, and could have you used a different expression? Answer this question in the comments below this video. Also remember, guys, if you like this video lesson, make sure to like it, hit subscribe and turn on notifications so that you get the notification, the bell icon, when I post my next video lesson here. If you found this video lesson useful, I have other great lessons for you to watch to improve your pronunciation. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for being here. And I look forward to seeing you in my next lesson. Bye for now.